I'm Stephen Holt. Welcome to something you've never seen before on the Stephen Holt Show ever in our 21 years. It's Provincetown. We're at the Provincetown Film Festival in Provincetown, Massachusetts. I just got off the ferry, Bay State Cruises, that comes over from Boston to here. And it's also glamorous and exciting. And the festival is just bursting with activity. And I just can't wait to show it to you. So, well, we're going to be meeting our charming hosts at the Beacon-like Guests House, Mark and Keith. And I think I see Mark pulling up right now. Okay, stick around and come on. And now, here we are, happily ensconced in the Beacon-like Guest House. And this was the wonderful host who met me in the lovely red car yesterday. It's Mark. I don't even know your last name, Mark.
Phillips.
Mark Phillips. Yeah. And your partner?
Keith Wilkinson.
Keith Wilkinson. Welcome, Keith. And you're British and you're American. And love it here. And they've been great and they're so wonderful. And you've got to come here to the Beacon-like Guest House in Provincetown. Now, you tell them why they should come.
Well, Provincetown's an amazing little place. It's a Portuguese fishing village that most people don't realize it, but the pilgrims first landed here in 1620.
And there was a monument you pointed out.
There's a pilgrim monument. It's celebrating its 100th year, the centennial.
And I saw that as I came over on the ferry. That was the first thing I saw. And American theater also pretty much was born here.
Provincetown
Players.
The Provincetown Players.
And Gene O'Neill.
That's right. And Tennessee Williams. All wrote their plays here during the summer in Provincetown.
And performed them. O'Neill had a house.
He did.
The Provincetown Playhouse at the end of a dock.
On one of the wharfs.
The backdrop would come up and there was the sea.
Yeah, there was the play. Yeah. That's right, yeah.
I think what happened to Mark and I was what happens to most people when they visit Provincetown. We came here on a family vacation. We brought the kids with us and the buckets and the spades and the flip-flops. And we fell in love with Provincetown in 2004 and just happened to hear that the Beacon Light was for sale. And then 6 months later, we owned it. That really is the story. That's exactly how it happened.
And if people want to find you on the internet, they can go to
www.beaconlightguesthouse.com.
And the service here is just great, and you serve a beautiful breakfast.
Thank you,
we try to...
We're in the kitchen, by the way. That's what we started here, because it has the most light. It's a beautiful room and it's very homey. Should we go to another part of the your beautiful building?
We'll give you a little tour.
Okay, great. So now here we are outside at the Beacon Light Guest House, and there's one of the beacon lights right there. And you'll notice this is actually a two-house combo, put together a gay mansion here in gayer than springtime Provincetown. And you're going to tell us all about your different rooms and things here at your beautiful Beacon Light Guest House?
Sure. Yeah, I mean, here at the Beacon Light, we have a total of 14 rooms. We have a number of levels of rooms. We have a standard queen room, for instance. The San Catti is one of those. All of the rooms are actually named after lighthouses or,
or
beaches that are on and around the Cape.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
And the San Catti room is, as I said, one of our standard queens, private bath. It has its own private entrance as well at the original side of the house, which is quite a nice feature. And then we also have some superior queens. The superior queen.
Myself included, yes.
Yeah, of course. an example of one of those would be the Chatham room, which is fairly unique. You step down into the Chatham, has a cathedral ceiling, lots of natural daylight. It's got 8 windows in that room, so if you like daylight, it's a great place. One bathroom is larger there as well.
If you want to sleep late, don't sleep in that room, right?
It has a unique view of the hot tub, which is
fairly
popular with some of our guests.
I want to see that room, yes.
And then, of course, right at the top of our range, we have a number of suites. The Beacon Light Suite, which is the entire third floor.
Which is where I'm staying.
And that's the room that you're staying in, Stephen, yeah? That's a beautiful room, again, right up on the third floor level. Lots of space.
3 times the size of my New York apartment, I have to tell you.
And we also have the Plymouth Suite, which, again, is on the original side of the house. Physical one-bed suite, seating area, obviously private bathroom. TVs, DVDs, VCRs, fireplaces, of course, gas fireplace in the Beacon Light and the Plymouth. And then the Pièce de Résistance, which is our number one room, is the Cape Ann. That's the very romantic, I guess you could call it the honeymoon suite or the getaway suite. And that has the wood floors and the oak beams and the real fireplace.
Oh, wow.
Canopy, king-size bed. And again, it's in the original house.
And a hot tub.
And a hot tub.
Which we may or may not get to see. But and your room, the thing is, it's so beautiful. Each room is like totally different. Andrew was saying it was like a fun house because you never know what to expect as you went from room to room. Yeah. With a particularly British touch, sir. And I love that. It's like a cozy British...
It is a
cottage in the Cotswolds, except it's not.
Exactly.
And the story of how you guys met, and we're both married to women, and now you're married to each other, because in Massachusetts, you can do this. I don't want to leave. I want to get married here. Anyway, but it's being here, it's like one wedding after another. Every day there's a wedding going on downstairs. They're getting ready for a wedding on the beach.
Yeah, we even have a wedding here this weekend, so. And that's the fourth or fifth we've had this spring.
I went to the press office, there was a lesbian wedding going on. Everywhere! There's brides and grooms and grooms and brides.
And grooms, and grooms and grooms.
And grooms and grooms and brides mainly. And it's June, so what did
that's
I expect?
Right. That's
the
right.
Five season.
Yeah, exactly.
But so, and you're both married too, which is wonderful.
Yeah, we were married June of 06, so we just celebrated our third anniversary. Yeah.
We got married on the beach, Provincetown Harbor.
Oh, wow. And you've got, nice. And you both have children.
You do, we do.
And one of your children is actually your son, Harry, is here.
Yeah, Harry's here working for the summer, yeah. Yeah, 14-year-old, he's decided he needs to buy stuff, so he has to have a job to buy the stuff, so.
Okay.
We lock him in the basement, tied to the ironing board, and that's what he does for the whole
season. Oh, okay.
He's laundry boy.
He is. Okay, I see how that works. Okay. And there's this wonderful, now if we can swing around and get a shot of that incredible staircase. At the top of that incredible staircase, which I'm not walking up again, unusual.
It is unusual. It's the largest roof deck in town, and it was added when the Beacon Light was expanded in the mid-80s, and it was the last roof deck that was put up in town. So we're very lucky to have it. It's a bit of a unique feature, and as you can tell, it's quite large. There's 15 sun chairs up there, and our guests spend a lot of time in the summer catching some good sun rays up there.
Yeah, that's why it's not high blood pressure, it's a sunburn, okay? So how did you two meet?
We met at work. We were both working, and we met in Miami Beach.
Yes, we did.
Yeah. In 2000.
Yeah.
And we started dating then, and here we are now.
Yep. The rest is history. Exactly. Well, the world loves a love story, and you make all your guests so comfortable here and so welcome. And
thank you. We try very hard.
With a great sense of humor.
Well, that's the British in me, I guess. A little sarcasm helps, I think, in most situations.
Yes, and we have, our fathers were both born in Liverpool.
Yes, the great place to be born.
The city of comedians.
God's own land, as my dad would say.
Did he really? I never heard that one before, because it rains all the time. Anyway, we've got to go now, and I want to thank our lovely hosts, Mark and Keith, here at the Beacon Light Guest House. Come one, come all, come now. You can't miss this place in Provincetown, Massachusetts. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Steve. Pleasure.